Hey guys, and welcome back to Thornton Farm. Now then, in today's episode, we are going to be selling the wood chips. Now last night we had the Merlot delivered with the 6.5 ton bucket, the log grab, and also the work platform thing. This cost us just over £90,000. I think it was £97,000, something like that. We've also got £100,000 loan, but hopefully we make about £170,000 from this wood chips. We've already filled up the trailer. We're going to fill up both the Unimogs, drive them down. And we're also going to do a bit of a selling spree as well, some of the equipment. Not really a selling spree, more of a buying spree, as soon as we get some more equipment. So hopefully that should be quite good. The Merlot, I think it's version 3, and I was playing around with this earlier when loading up these wood chips, and it's a lot more responsive than the JCB. Just hydraulics, they work a lot faster. It's got a few more features as well, like the opening doors as well. As well, top right, I don't know if you see the FPS there. Has anyone else had this issue with the placeable heaps, where the FPS just drops suddenly when like loading or unloading? So I've had that. And it's kind of annoying, because I don't really know what's causing it. I mean, it didn't really happen with the grass, it was just the wood chips that it started with. I mean, what, 20 FPS there, 30 FPS when unloading. We get about 9 FPS when actually loading. I don't know what's causing that. Hopefully it's nothing bad. Anyway, going back to this Merlot, brilliant piece of equipment. It's got the all-wheel steer, crab steer, and front-wheel steer. This one isn't the one with the linkage on the back. It just has a normal attacher, which can go up and down and that. Side door as well, I like that top window open. Quite good. Hopefully it should be useful to us. Now I am still looking for a telehandler log fork, but I can't find any about, well, that work and are from decent links, because my security software keeps blocking some of the pages which it thinks, well, which are bit dodgy, and that's the only places where there are links to these log forks and that. So I'm really quite good with this weight as well. It's it actually works as if there's something heavy on the front, which, to be honest, it's about 6 ton on the front. So yeah, it's about, what, 6.5 ton on the front there. If we do about 1,000 litres of wood chips, it's about a ton. It's rather heavy, but it seems to be coping rather well. Lights work on it, so we've got rear lights, indicators. No reversing lights, it seems. It's a bit odd. Or reversing beeper. sort of expect that. So, hopefully this works rather well. I mean, if we do start to get issues with the log handling and that, I will just give up on using this. We'll just go, well, give this back, get a bit of a refund slightly. No, it doesn't really quite work like that, but yeah. Then we'll move back to JCB, but I do like this currently. Oh, I like the joystick there, that's really quite good. That's basically mimicking what my mouse is doing. Hydraulics as well, if you look at what the joystick's doing, they're fairly... Not as responsive, but they're still fairly good. Probably making some of you sick now. Anyway, let's back this up. Then we'll go to the wood chip selling point. I'm hoping to get a fair amount of money out of this. Like I said, £170,000. Hopefully, we'll get a bit more though. Because what I am wanting to do is get some of the IT runner stuff. So instead of constantly using... let's just go find it a second. Instead of constantly using that log carrier, we could have a much larger one, which we just load logs on using Merlot there. And we can have, well, we can bring it back here and unload and wood chip them. And I'd also like a grain trailer instead of this one. That's tiny, 15,000 litres in there. Nothing, we could do with a lot more. Yeah, so just have to wait for that to clear. Yeah, hopefully it is quite good. Let's hope that hasn't gone past yet. Right. I don't think it's going past. What, about 20 ton on the back is that? If we're doing that, so it easily drives over vehicles. Is yeah, not the best thing on earth to be doing, but I mean we move the equipment fairly well. Put that to 15 meters behind. Hopefully that will work. Wood chip sell point is at the shop as well, so I didn't check how many tons of wood chips there is left. So we got 6.5 there, just say 7. Ah, yeah, so we can sell the trailer whilst we are at the shop, which is good. As it means that we don't have to bring it back with us, and it'll be a full one of these. So this will be full, the other one, because it's on road tyres, not as much grip. We'll just fill that up with the remaining 10,000 litres, I think, or 15. No, that'd be 10,000 litres, I think. So, well, I did remove the map, bottom left hand corner. I probably will get around to turning off the daytime clock, the money, and that at some point. I'm a bit more confident with just, yeah, knowing where everything is, how much money we got, what time it is, make sure that I don't accidentally speed up the time like that. And no other four-wheel drives on. Even if there was indicators in here that that works, telling me if four-wheel drive was on diff locks, I'd probably definitely turn it off. I better not be stuck. I believe we go into the shop as well to sell the wood chips. I don't think there's any other entrance into that section. I think it's directly on the wood, on the shop's property. Interesting to see. Right, there we go, follow me, mod's gone off. We've gone too far ahead. We'll drive that up in a minute. First off though, turn into here and we will sell our wood chips. We see that the money rolling in. It's going to be quite good. This looks like we'll have to drop this off first. This trailer. I mean, it's done quite good. But because these are 20,000 litre capacity on the back here, maybe not surrealistic, but. See there as well, it goes down after a while. I had that issue the other day when we were doing the wood chips. As well, I did do the stump grinding, so I thought that was a bit easier to do. See how much money we got from this so far. £73,000. So we got the majority out the way there. I don't think we'll get much more. Still at £2,000 though. So technically we should get £40,000 for this. We'll just see if that's actually how it works. Cause yeah, if we got 30, oh well, if we don't get all of the money that we need, we'll just have to wait for the money to come through. We did get paid £15,000 for the tree clearing job as well. And we're also getting the money from the wood chips, so it's all rather good. So I've got two Unimogs there, that lorry, which is quite good. That is the shop's lorry. We don't actually own that. How much should we get for that then? £41,000. That's good. So that means that the money is going in the correct direction. I mean, we did start off with not a lot, put it that way. £9,000, I think, or £8,000. I mean, if we we could get rid of the loan and have not much money, or we could get rid of the £50,000 which I took out not so long ago to get the Merlot, and we could then work so that we get another £50,000. I mean, the big job which I've got planned for the shed for the farmer, that's fairly soon. We've still got the pub to do, roundabout, do at some point. So yeah, that is still on our agenda to do. The church we got done. That's quite good. It's growing back fairly quickly though, actually. And yeah, that's good. Thought that was green now, actually. Don't pull out, you nutter. Says the person that pulled out on a red. Actually, did that turn green? Because I believe that those traffic lights actually stop vehicles which run following the mod. So I'll have to drive down here fairly quickly. Hopefully I can overtake. Nope. Just undertake so I've got no cars in between, that's good. We didn't even sell that trailer though, did we? I need to do that. I was thinking about selling the log carrier thing that we've got with the grapple. But that's sort of useful. At times, so I think we'll keep that for now. If it turns out that we really don't need it, I will sell it, because we can get what, £30,000 for that, I think. So that is fairly good. So while someone gave me a link to a push mower, we now have that in the game. It works. Not the greatest textures on it, but it's still a push mower, which we could have done with a while ago. Where's that going? Yes, so are there any jobs where you would like me to use that push mower? If there are, please put them in the comments below, as I probably will do some job where there's a push mower involved. Of course that doesn't make it. Although what we can do is we can turn this around. Annoying. I might actually move the triggers there, and that triggers the collisions, as I could do with no collisions on that hedge, as they are a bit of an issue. That's it. I just paused. Bunch of wood chips on the ground, never to be gone back. It turns out there are no playgrounds which could do us wood chips, so it turns out we're just selling them. That, or I didn't want them. Yeah. Wouldn't quite fancy landing on them, really. Be better than concrete. Not much more to do now. It says there, what, 10,000 litres left in there, and that U400 is however full it is. Pokemon Go app as well. I also find it funny, the amount of people which I've seen walking about playing it. It's incredibly funny. I might have to give it a go. Maybe, I don't know. Might do a video on it. Possibly. That'd be quite cool. Let's see what all the hype is about. Because I could... Well, I'd like to know what it's about, really. I think I got it yesterday. Tried to get an account, and it said that the account sign-up thing is broken. Because there's that many people using it, that the app is now broken for signing up. So I might have to do it with a Google account, maybe. Find a different way to get a Pokemon account. And I've personally never played it. All I know is that Pikachu is that yellow thing. That's all I know about Pokemon. So it will be an experience if I ever get around to playing it. Or can ever play it, really, because of these accounts, which they don't really let you create now. It would be rather good if I could have a wood chip sell point just over the road. Hint to self, add in with Giant's editor. As well, the reset point for vehicles, I'm going to move that, because I've got to drive them halfway across the map, and I might as well just drive them from the shop. So reset point will be in that field over there somewhere. Because it's rather annoying. You go there, you want to get your new vehicle, drive it to HQ, and it turns out that it's miles away. It's at the farm there, in the centre of the map, near enough to centre. It's alright, because I did test out that topper there, and there's just a strip of grass missing. But yeah, it's a pain. We've got to do that as well, the windmill, we've got to cut that. So that could be next episode. I might try and do something with the push mower though. You know what, actually, the pub, we can cut part of that with the push mower and the stand on, possibly the sit on. I mean, it's actually quite a big garden that they've got. And I mean, the strimmer is what I would have used there. However, it doesn't work, so the push mower is the next option. Gardens as well. Every time I drive past it, I do look at the grass and think, I don't need cutting. Apart from that, there. But I believe that's not one of the council houses. So the council don't pay us to cut those gardens. However, the one there on the corner, that possibly is, that's a private residence. Not possibly, yes, it is. It's a private residence, so might end up cutting the grass for that at some point. And that would be a push mower job. Do the whole thing with it. Push mower, not very wide, but what do you expect? It's for like gardens the size of that front piece there. Whilst we're waiting for that to catch up, let's sell this. Hopefully we get £10,000 maybe? No, not even that. That's just gonna so £127,000. I'm looking for a lot more than that. From this, it should be £20,000. Might actually get, if I can, well, if I can get, I think it's £178,000, which I'm looking for, then my calculations were correct. Oh no, I think that might be 177, actually, but yeah. We get to 70. 74. Brilliant. Made our money back. Now it's time to spend it again. Right, let's just... This video is going to be a long one, I think. Let's do a quick calculation of how much it will cost for the IT runner stuff. If I can find it. There we go. So, £55,000. I'd probably go for the grain container there, so that's 42. £97,000 plus that wood container, that's it. £106,000. So, 174 minus 106. We can pay back £68,000. I don't know what's best actually, to go for the skip, the grain container. We need that in any case. That is like half price of that. That's cheaper per day, but only by £10. Wood container, we need that anyway. Right, skip all the container. The container's quite large, that actually. We'll go for that, which we need. We'll go for it in orange, I think. Wrong colour, but it will do. So we have this equipment here. That's ours. I thought that was a lot bigger, actually. It turns out it's not. So, one problem here. Can this pull it? I'd be surprised if it can. Has it got enough? See, no PTO there. Unrealistic, but I don't know. Let's say it's running off a hydraulics, and a hydraulic pump is on the Uniwell. That is going to be a lot easier for the wood chips to go in. Then on the back of this. So I have an idea on what I can do to get it back, or get it all back as one. You may think this is actually stupid, which it probably is. However, we've got this lorry at our disposal, so we may as well use it. Right, let's see if this works. I'd be very surprised if we can do this first time. Look at them wheels on there. Let's hope it actually fits as well. It looks like we've done it. It Wrong thing to disconnect. Brilliant, we've done it. Didn't think I'd do that. Right, before next episode, these will go back to our yard. Yes, so thanks for watching, guys. Really hope you've enjoyed this episode. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share this video, as it really does help. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.